Welcome back. In this video, we're going to take a look at how to record some transactions using T-accounts. Remember, using T-accounts is a critical part of your learning accounting, so this is something you're really going to need to get used to and practice with. T-accounts can be set up in a number of ways. Sometimes you can set T-accounts up as you see here if you like to categorize them based on the basic accounting equation, assets equals liabilities plus equity. That's fine. Sometimes when you're working with T-accounts, you'll just scatter them across the page, and that's okay too, because as we're working with these accounts, you'll begin to notice that if you do them correctly and follow the debit and credit rules, your basic accounting equation will stay in balance as we go along, and I'll talk more about that as we go. So let's take a look at the first transaction for this company that says we received $12,000 cash by issuing or selling common stock. Now, when you're recording this transaction using T-accounts, you can really begin with the debit or credit side. It doesn't really matter as long as you end up with your debits and credits equaling at the end. What I usually like to do when working through transactions like this is to focus first on cash. If a transaction involves cash, I always like to start there because it's fairly easy to determine what happened to cash. In this case, since the company sold stock, they received $12,000 cash in return. So we're going to come down here to the cash T account. Now, cash falls under the asset category, and hopefully you have your normal balances already memorized. If not, you should have your cheat sheet out. Since cash is an asset, all assets increase on the debit. And remember, debit means left side of the T account. So we're just going to take and we're going to put a $12,000 entry to the left side of cash here. That takes care of one side of the entry. The other side of the entry will go to an equity account called common stock. And again, if you have memorized your normal balances, equity accounts typically increase on the credit or right side of the T account. So we're going to come down here to common stock and increase that account $12,000 as well. Now you can see here that our debits equal our credits. That's one rule. The other thing that matters here is that our basic accounting equation is still in balance. And like I said before, as long as you follow the debit credit rules, most likely that'll be the case. Let's take a look at step two here. It says we perform services of $700 on account. Now remember, under accrual-based accounting rules, we can record service revenue when it's performed. Now it doesn't matter that we have not received the cash yet because it says it's on account, meaning we billed the customers. The answer is no. What we would do in this situation is instead of recording an increase to cash, we'd record an increase to another asset called accounts receivable. Remember, accounts receivable is the account we use to record amounts due from customers. So we're going to take an increase this asset for $700. Remember, assets increase on the debit left side. Likewise, we're going to come down here to our service revenue account, and we're going to increase this by $700 as well, but on the credit side. Revenue accounts typically increase on the credit right side. Now, you may be looking at this and wondering, well, why didn't we, in fact, retain earnings like we did in the first couple of chapters? Well, if you recall, the calculation of revenues minus expenses equals net income. That calculation or that net income is then transferred to retained earnings during the closing process at the end of the accounting period. There's no need to reflect that now because those entries will actually happen later during that step, during the closing process steps. So what we're doing now is we're just recording the original entry to service revenue, but we can be assured that once that closing process takes place, an increase, in this case, an increase to revenue would be an increase in net income, and that net income increase would increase retained earnings. An increase to retained earnings would then bring us in balance. So once again, our accounting equation would remain in balance. Take a look at step three. Step three says we paid wages of $1,400 to employees. Now again, this word paid indicates that cash, in this case, actually went down. So if cash is an asset and increases on the debit left side, it must decrease then logically on the credit right side. So if we paid these wages, what we're going to do is we're going to come over here to the credit right side and decrease cash $1,400. That's the credit side of the entry. Of course, we'll need a debit to go along with that credit. So down here, you'll notice in the wages or the revenues and expense areas, we have something called wages expense. Expenses increase on the debit left side. That's its normal balance, and that's what we're doing here. We're increasing an expense. So we're going to come down here for step three here. We'll put a increase of $1,400 to the wages expense account on the debit left side. And again, our rules are in place where our credits equal our debits. And once again, as these amounts, revenues and expenses, are transferred to retained earnings, that's what will get us in balance here at the end with the basic accounting equation. Okay, let's take a look at step four. Step four says we performed $850 of services, this time for cash. This is a little different than the earlier one where we performed services on account. This time we performed the services, so we earned the revenue, and we actually received the cash on the spot. So cash, once again, will increase on the debit left side. So we'll come under here and just add another entry right below the other one for $850. And then we'll increase revenue on the credit right side, just like before. The only difference with this one is we received cash, whereas the one before was on account. Step five says we paid $2,000 of dividends to stockholders. Let's start with the cash part of this. It says we paid $2,000, so we want to decrease cash by $2,000. And we're going to decrease cash on the credit right side. So we'll put that over there on the credit right side. Now, dividends are a little unique. A lot of people mistakenly think dividends are expenses, and they're not. A dividend, when a dividend is paid by the company, it's really just a reduction of capital or return of their equity. So in this case, the debit side of this entry, remember we need a debit to go along with this credit, the debit side is going to go to an equity account called dividends, and we're going to increase that dividends account on the debit left side. The dividends account's a little bit unique. It's what we consider to be a contra equity account, a contra equity account. The reason we call it contra, meaning opposite, is because equity accounts normally increase on the credit right side. And of course, this account increases on the debit left side. So this will actually reduce equity overall. So again, debits equal credits, and our basic account equation is in balance as well. Okay, let's take a look at the last one. The last step says that we collected $400 cash from receivables. So first, let's start by recording the cash portion of this entry, which is an increase to cash. So we're going to want to put that, we've got to squeeze this in here, not a lot of space. We'll squeeze this in on the debit left side here of our cash T account. I'm going to extend the line down here a little bit. So by putting it on the debit left side, we're indicating that we're increasing cash. Now, it says that we collected this cash from receivables. Well, if you recall, it's talking about this earlier entry here where we had increased accounts receivable $700. What we need to do here now is put the credit side of this entry to show, or on the accounts receivable account, to show that we're actually reducing the accounts receivable balance by the amount of this payment. So a debit to cash and a credit to accounts receivable. The nice thing about T accounts is that at any point in time, you could stop and look to see an account balance. For instance, if we were going to look at the balance in cash, what we'd have to do is we'd have to add up all of the entries on the debit side here, and then subtract the entries on the credit side, and that net debit balance would be the balance in our cash account. Likewise, you can see here in accounts receivable, we increased it over here on the debit left side for $700, and then later on we received a partial payment on that account for $400. So you can see here that our customers still owe us a net balance of $300, which hopefully we'll receive a little bit later.